Necessarily better. How will the merger allow you to keep pace within the changing global marketplace?
Good question. As you know, both CCI and Techhausen are family-run companies.
We will treat our shareholders and our customers as part of our extended family.
My vice president of strategic planning is Jennifer Morgan. And, of course, you know my dear friend Carl Hausen, founder and CEO of Techhausen.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. And my children, Michael and Cassandra.
Over here.
Good afternoon. With the recent...
Miss Morgan, excuse me. Is it true you were once an au pair to Mr. Caldwell's children?
Yes, Miss Morgan, is that true?
Yes, you wrote that.
Yes,
Ron. A babysitter to boardroom in 1 year? That's pretty fast.
Just a moment, please. Miss Morgan was instrumental in last year's restructuring of CCI, and she has been a key player
Miss
in this
Morgan,
merger.
Over
what
here.
About the rumors that you two are romantically involved?
Miss Morgan, would you like to comment on your Cinderella romance?
Ladies and gentlemen, please. Today is not about fairy tales.
Indeed. Thank you all for coming. Enjoy the afternoon.
I thought you were going to give a brilliant speech, brother dear.
Yeah, couldn't get a word in edgewise, could I? It was all about Jenny and Oliver.
Poor Papa, you know how he detests mixing business with personal matters. I thought he was going to back out of the merger right then and there.
SkyCam 1 to Landbase. I'm airborne and flying high. Do you read me, Landbase? Over.
Oh, please. Can we have a few stupid code names?
Do you want to do this or not?
Yeah, but Kate...
Look, this is your dopey project, Alex. SkyCam 1, or I go do my nails.
Fine. Whatever. Just give me a few more minutes. There's like a gazillion wires up here.
Landbase, this is SkyCam 1. Is everybody there?
Yeah, Dad and Jenny are talking to those reporters. What else? I don't see anything. Who is she?
Who?
No, I'm just looking at a couple of boring suits. Oh, watch out! I see Grandma!
What's with that hat?
Carl, having this showcase here on your estate was an excellent idea.
Oh, Oliver, this is such a wonderful gathering, and as always, I am so proud of you,
Thank
Carl.
Thank you, man. Extraordinary hat. Oliver, you know I've always thought of you like a son.
Oh, I feel a fatherly talk coming on.
I must ask you to keep your personal life separate from our business venture. Jennifer, she's a lovely young woman. I understand you fancy her.
She's more than a fancy, Carl. She's a part of my life.
Look, keep it low profile. Our shareholders prefer it. Our board will insist. Jennifer.
Hello. Mr. Hausen seems a little tense. Is everything all right?
Everything's fine. What do you think of the cake?
I know it looks too beautiful to eat, but we'll be cutting it in about 10 minutes. It is a replica of my grandfather's castle in Bohemia.
You handled the press perfectly.
Well, I learned from the best. Although I wish they would drop all of that Cinderella nonsense. After all, I hardly ever see the prince.
I know. I've been preoccupied lately. We've both been.
I just miss you. So do Katie and Alex.
Never learn their lesson.
No, signore, no,
come on. It's a private party.
Where are the kids?
I don't know. Seamus, have you seen Katie and Alex anywhere?
No, not for some time.
Oh, Seamus, I see you've been at the food trough.
Ah, Mrs. Grayson, what a very lovely hat.
Skycam one to land base. We have a green light. Over.
So nobody knows where the kids are?
Oh, Oliver, I cannot be expected to mind the children without some support from Miss Morgan.
I'm sure that they're fine. They're probably just mingling with the other guests.
Here goes. Helicopter cam is on.
Yes! Kate, we did it!
Or not.
Now commencing party flyover.
So that's what they're up to.
It's a nice touch, don't you think? Camera on a helicopter. Oh, Mrs. G, smile.
Oh, come on. It's only a harmless prank.
One, two, three.
That's what you think.
Uh-oh.
This is Grandma.
Over and out. And give me this thing.
No, Grandma, don't touch it. Don't.
No, you can't touch that.
Why not?
Look what you're doing.
Look.
Oh. At your father's important business gathering. What were you thinking?
We were just trying to liven things up a little, Grandma. Yeah, it was supposed to be a celebration.
Right.
We wanted to be a part of it, too. Like Jenny's new slogan, our family working for yours. Everyone was enjoying it.
Well, I wasn't. I demand that my grandchildren are better behaved. Romping around like circus clowns. Oh, if your dear mother could have seen this.
No.
My daughter Emily would never have encouraged such blatant disrespect.
I don't necessarily think that's...
Luggage? You're sending us home? We just got here.
Oh, I should. But luckily for you, Jenny talked me out of it. Listen, you guys, we still have a few days before the shareholders vote, and since the Housens have been generous enough to allow us to stay here as their guests, we're going to have a little time to spend together.
Yahoo!
But let's try not to burn the house down completely, all right? And guys, I want to keep the noise to a minimum. I don't want Carl Housen disturbed in any way.
Oh, Father left hours ago, so go crazy.
For where?
He took his yacht up for the weekend. Didn't he tell you? Well, Father does put a high premium on privacy and discretion.
Well, that's too bad. I was hoping to map a little corporate strategy with him before the meeting.
Well, Cassandra and I can help you out there. We do speak for Father's interests, after all.
Hold on a minute. If we're not leaving, whose luggage is this?
Well, Jenny and I do still have a little work to do, and we can't have your grandma chasing after you all the time.
So we had to call in reinforcements.
An old pair?
Everyone's in here, I believe.
Sam!
Hey, kids, how you doing? Good to see ya. Boy, have you grown. Hey, how about this place, huh? Like it's right out of a fairy tale. Nellie!
You remember my father?
Vividly.
Hi, sweetheart. Oh, it's good to see you.
You must be exhausted. Do you want some rest after your long flight?
Rest? I'm here in Europe. This time not courtesy of the Army. Hey, how you doing, Oliver?
Good.
All right. Which one of you is going to give me the 10-cent tour, huh?
Both of us. Come on.
Okay, see you later.
I'll show you where to put Mr.
Morgan.
Morgan's luggage.
I can't thank you enough for all your generosity.
Oh, don't be silly. We're practically family, after all.
Alone at last.
Thanks for flying Dad out. He was so excited about coming here, and he was all packed and ready to go before we even got off the phone.
I'm thrilled he's here.
Besides, the kids adore him.
It is so beautiful here.
Yes, it is. Although it's never looked quite as enchanting to me as it does right this minute.
What's the matter? You're all pouty.
Look at them. Just when Father is about to retire and hand the company to us, he decides to merge with Mr. Teflon in the Cinderella MBA. Have you seen this? I mean, have you taken a good look at it? Because I'll tell you something, there's not a single picture of us.
But don't you see? This is our way in. Our hook.
What are you talking about, hook?
You saw what happened today. The press loves a real-life fairy tale. Rich man meets working girl, they fall in love, live happily ever after. But nowadays, what the media thrives on are the grim fairy tales.
Go on.
If we're to take control of this company, you and I have to drive a wedge between the lovebirds, drum up scandal. Make Daddy and his board members hit the ceiling. In short, divide and conquer.
Or, better yet, divide and crush.
Homemade donuts.
Mademoiselle, please, let me do something.
Relax, I love to cook. Come here, sit down. Try one of my donuts. Read the newspaper. Hey.
Hi.
Who's your friend?
Brigitte Chabot, enchanté.
Cassandra and Michael's niece. She's on a break from boarding school.
Come on, give me your best.
Come on,
right here.
Oh, yes. Mother's in Milan right now, shopping for fancy clothes. And a new husband. Personally, I prefer blue jeans and neigeux.
What's neigeux?
It means snowy in French.
Hey, Snowy. Aren't you a big cutie?
Yeah. You what?
Me? No. I grew up in L.A. The closest thing I came to a horse was rebuilding a 65 Mustang. Oh, the waffles. I gotta go. I hope you'll join us for breakfast.
Your mother seems very nice. Jenny, she's not my mom. My mom died. Oh, sorry. It was a long time ago. Jenny's amazing. I wish Dad would marry her.
What's stopping him?
Men. Who can figure him?
Heads up! Oh! Move, Alex.
Well, if it isn't Mr. Cleanbook.
This time it wasn't my fault. Hey, Dad, did I kick this ball? See? All right, here we go. Come on.
You're related? Only by birth. That's my brother, and that's my dad.
Hey, oh, get it. Oh.
He's cute. My dad? Him too.
Center it. Stop it.
Go.
Ah. So, you do understand what we need from you?
Yes.
Good.
You got the money?
Yes, of course. Of course. Half now, half of the job's complete.
Bruce, expenses.
Well, how did it go?
He's in. And America's most precious family are all going on a bike ride together.
How very healthy. I'll handle it from here. Good morning, Mrs. Grayson.
Please, it's Nell. And thank you for those fresh donuts.
Donuts? Why, yes, of course. So do you and your grandchildren travel often together?
Well, I'm also here for the shareholders meeting. I'm custodian of the children's stock portfolio. They own a healthy chunk of Oliver's company.
You don't say.
Get your helmets on. Let's go.
Dad, where are we going?
Well, it's a surprise. Find out when we get there.
Okay. Hey, Nellie, want to jump out of 10 feet and join us?
No, it is Nell! Hurry up, Seamus.
Hey, Jenny, look for lunch.
That's a surprise, too.
Last one there does the dishes.
Come on, Dad. Raise you. Bye-bye. Oh, you're it. Oh. Woo! Yeah! Oh!
Gorgeous, Oliver. I think this is the most romantic spot I've ever been in my life.
I thought you'd like it.
Hey, look, somebody's having a party up there.
Yoo-hoo, Oliver! Come and join us!
No time at all.
Tender greet.
Oh, man, look at this spread, Maggie. Look at this cake.
I thought we were just having a simple picnic.
So did I.
Hey, old man. Jenny, how was your little ride?
What is all this?
Oh, well, see, here's the thing. The figures just weren't lining up with the Belgian operation. So Cass and I felt it was vital that we dive in right away in order to stay on track with the shareholders' report deadline. You do agree?
Yes, of course, it's important, but...
I spoke with Father. He's hoping to get our report this evening.
I really don't like to cancel family outings. It's not fair to the kids.
Oh, come on. We'll hash it out over lunch. It'll be done.
I called my caterers, had them rush over a little bite. But first, I'd like you to meet somebody very important.
Nell?
Yes?
There's someone over here just dying.
Jenny, we can still have our picnic, can't we?
Of course. Come on, are you kidding?
So, Jenny, I have a copy of the data for you as well, in case you have any questions.
Just one, Michael.
Couldn't this wait?
Oh, well, Oliver was fine with it. I just assumed that... Oh, you're upset. I feel horrible. I know it's none of my business, but I can understand how this relationship can be stressful for you at times.
Oh, no, not at all. Oliver is great.
Well, if you want me to go over any of this with you, I'd be happy to.
Oh, no, Michael, that's okay. I think Oliver will catch me up.
Oh!
What's the matter?
Oh, something flew into my eye, I think. I can't see.
Oh, hold on. Let me see.
Can you see? It seems to...
I'll try. Can you get it open? Look up. See if you can...
Can you try it?
No, I don't see anything. I mean... Does it feel like it's gone?
Oh, wait. Fine.
Oh, okay.
Strangest
good.
Thing.
Yeah, it happens.
Well, thanks.
No problem.
So, enjoy your, ride. Bye.
Look at that thing. That's chocolate cake.
Jenny made our lunch.
It had nut filling.
You've got nut filling, stupid.
Hey!
Bon voyage, Jenny. Bon voyage, Sam.
Last one across is a rotten egg. There's more boats over there. Come on!
Come on, guys!
Okay.
We'll spread out the food.
Come get it before the ants do.
What's wrong?
Well, once again, Jenny's down there. And
Dad's up there.
Oh, I see. It's really a shame they can't be together.
Yeah.
Listen carefully. Now, Jenny and your father belong together, love each other, no?
No. Yeah. Yes, absolutely.
Yet he hasn't asked her to marry him. Why do you suppose that is?
Because he's always too darn swamped with his work.
Hello? I believe Brigitte and I were having a private conversation. You were saying?
If you want them to be together, if you want to be a family, you must get Jenny and your father alone, someplace quiet. Romantic.
Come on, Brigitte, let's go get the boat.
Shouldn't we wait for Alex?
No. Now, come on.
Quiet and romantic. Quiet and romantic.
Stay there, guys. Have I got a job for you.
Mm-hmm. Right. Look, I need accurate information about that company, and I need it now. Thank you.
I could call my mother, sir. She does a little day trading on the web.
Is that right?
Her portfolio did 320% last year.
Really? She own any of my stuff?
I'd rather not say, sir. This just came in for you. It's about tonight's party.
They're leaving from the North Landing. What time's the cruise? 7 o'clock.
Yes. Hello.
I was wondering if you have any boats for hire.
7:30.
7:30 tonight. You do?
South Landing? I'll book that.
All we do is scan it in,
change the time to 7:30 so no one crosses paths,
and make the new location the South Landing where our boat will be waiting.
It'll be quiet and romantic. With any luck, we'll pop the question.
Yeah.
Awesome. Superbe. Let's do it.
First of all, don't panic.
Panic?
Well, you know the bullfrogs from the creek? Well, there are 12 of them, and now...
Right now, a dozen bullfrogs are running through this house?
More like hobbies.
Oh. Make sure they don't jump off the edge of the stairs.
Oh, yes. Gotcha.
Grab that. Grab that one down. Grab that. Here. Okay, I want you to take these frogs outside and set them free.
Dad, wait! Thanks for your help.
Sure. Hello there.
Hi.
What are you young ladies up to this afternoon?
Nothing. Everybody ready to go shopping?
Ready.
Head.
Where is everybody?
Seamus, are you sure this is the right place?
That's what the memo says.
Get this. They say the ship we chartered left from the North Dock half an hour ago.
What? You're kidding.
I wish I were. Sailed off downriver with all our execs on board. Not to mention a dozen Austrian bankers. How's that going to make us look?
How could they leave without us?
I don't know. This is a disaster.
Okay, calm down. It's just a logistical mix-up. I'm sure we can work it out.
Monsieur, you have mix-up? Yes?
Well, that's putting it mildly. We're supposed to be on a boat down a river.
Madame, I will take you. Come.
On that?
Oliver, that is so great of you, sir. Thank you so much. See? Don't you everything would work out?
I'll call the ship from the car, sir. Tell Michael and Cassandra and the others you're en route.
Thank you, James.
Let's go.
This line has been temporarily disconnected.
What the?
Battle station, this is land base.
I read you, land base. Over.
Operation Question Pop is afloat.
Excuse me, do you call this note?
Michael! Michael! Michael, where's Oliver? There are several bank presidents wanting to meet him.
From what I understand, he's downstairs behind closed doors, not to be disturbed.
Really? Quel dommage. I think it's time for our charming host and hostess to make an appearance, n'est-ce pas?
May we?
Oliver, everyone's wondering.
Oh, hi.
Alex, where's your father?
Oh, Dad, not a clue. Sorry.
I think it's kind of fun. You and me, alone, under the moonlight, all cuddled up.
Land base to battle station? Anytime you're ready.
Excuse me. Why have you stopped paddling? We have a meeting to get to. This really isn't a good time to... sir, I must insist that you...
What's he doing?
I'm not sure exactly. Yes, that's... This is lovely. Very nice. But we have a boat we need to get to, so... hello. Excuse me. Whoa, what are you doing, buddy?
Bonne nuit. Bonne chance. Bon appétit.
Oh. Hey! Hey, where are you going? What?
Battle station? I can't see anything. What are they doing? Yes, they're smiling!
What is this? Champagne, candlelight.
Music for your wedding.
Music for your... Why, those little sneaks.
they led us on a wild goose
chase, stranded us out here in the middle of the river, and you're laughing?
I wish I would have thought of it myself.
Oh, really? Is that right?
You should try one of these. They're so perfect.
No. I'm not gonna be a party to their childish antics. I think I can get this thing working again.
Champagne.
Well, I suppose it is sort of sweet in a
devious, manipulative. They're so grounded for life kind of way. And I suppose when you think about it, they do have a point.
What do you mean?
It's so obvious, Jenny. So right. You and me, the kids. From the moment that you first walked into my office, into our lives, there was a connection. You made us a family again, and we hadn't been for so long. I've been carrying this around for a few weeks now, waiting for the right moment. Jenny, will you marry me?
Yes! Say yes!
Yes.
Yes?
Yes, I would love to marry you, Oliver.
They're getting married! They're getting married!
Who is?
Dad and Jenny, he just proposed to Ralph on that boat.
How do you know that?
I gotta go call Grandpa Sam.
Grandpa? Oh, dear Lord, this night is getting bleaker by the hour.
So much for divide and conquer.
Au contraire. The fun has just begun.
Give us a hug.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Why are we whispering?
Oh, come here.
Voila! Eggs are ready.
Hope Kenny likes them goopy.
Toast is almost done. 3 points. The crowd goes wild. This is great. We should open a restaurant.
About last night, you know, the fireworks and the boat and stuff.
You guys were behind all that?
You idiot, she didn't know.
Idiot, she was kidding.
Maybe it was a little sneaky, but we just wanted Dad to get on with it, you know?
I think it was the sweetest, most beautiful thing anybody's ever done for me.
So after we're married, you know what I mean. We're all gonna live together, right?
Of course we are, you guys.
You know, in school months, and we're being shipped off to Grandma's.
We are a family now. From now on, you guys are going to be with your dad and me all the time.
So we always wanted me too.
Woo! Millie?
Oh, for God's sake, man, if you must skulk around like that, wear a bell. And for the last time, my name is Nell. Nellie sounds like an old milk cow.
Yeah, gotcha. It's wonderful news about Jenny and Oliver, huh? Guess we'll be seeing a lot more of each other from now on. You know, I'm going to be looking to you for a lot of advice. Never been a grandparent before.
Oh? Well, it's really rather simple. You pour all your time and your love and your care into helping your grandchildren grow up. And then one day, they grow away. And you're older. And you're not needed anymore. I guess I better put these in water.
Good morning, Nell.
Oh, hello, Cassandra. I snipped a few of your flowers. I hope you don't mind.
Oh, please, my home is your home.
You're very kind.
Where are the children?
Oh, they're off with Jenny somewhere, of course.
What is Oliver thinking? Granted, she's perky, bright, pretty, in an obvious provincial sort of way. Yet there's something about Jennifer, something so calculating.
What are you saying?
I want to believe fairy tales come true, but this one seems played out by design, as if someone is manipulating her own happily ever after.
Oh. And you think Jenny is responsible for this?
If Katie and Alex were my flesh and blood, I don't think I'd risk their portfolios falling into the hands of someone as publicity hungry as Jenny Morgan.
Hi.
Okay, folks, good work. Go get your bags back and meet downstairs in about 5 minutes.
There she is, barefoot bride-to-be. Congratulations.
How are the wedding plans going?
How are the what?
Okay, that's enough. Let's let the groom in here first.
If I'd known there was going to be a meeting, I would have been here. And what does he mean, wedding plans?
Mike, take over for me, will you?
Gladly.
We've got to fly to Barcelona for a couple of days, sort out some details.
You know what, if you don't need me, I'd love to stay here and work on my presentation. I could really use the time.
Sure, absolutely. There's one more thing. Cassandra and Michael have offered to host our wedding once the shareholders meeting is over. We could stay at their castle till then. It's nearby, it's quiet, it's
beautiful. Wait. You want to get married at the end of this week?
I know it's short notice, but hey, the whole family's here. We got the kids and Nell and Sam. Mostly, I just want to start being your husband, Jen. I just want to start our lives together as a family.
Well, who could refuse an offer like that?
Great. That's great.
Can it just be a small ceremony, just you and me and the kids and the family?
Whatever you want. Castle set you up with all the right people, and I'll take care of the honeymoon plans.
We better get to the airport.
Right.
Welcome to the new CCI Tech Housing. Our family working for yours.
Hey, Jenny.
Hi, Jenny.
Hey, guys.
Cool. Is that your presentation?
What there is of it. We're so high-tech and such a big company now that I'm trying to highlight some of the human aspects.
Where's Dad? He said he was going to take us riding with Brigitte today.
Oh, he had to go to Spain today.
Oh. Well, baby. Maybe you could come instead. Yeah, we could teach you how to ride.
Listen, you guys, I really want to, but
you know, Jenny, I'm just sick and tired of you hogging these kids all the time. I mean, I flew all the way over here and, well, I think now it's my turn. Come on, guys, let's go.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Come on, Sam. Sam, you ever ride a horse before?
A horse? Does a merry-go-round count?
All right, Sam, there you go. Up. Okay. All right. There you go.
Whoa.
All right. Yes. Come on. Ready to go, Sam. Woo! There you go. Come on.
Got me.
Whoa.
Go.
Good job, Sam.
All right, hey, how do I make this thing go, guys?
Hit the accelerator. Right. The shift into first.
Okay, here we go.
Right.
Knock, knock. I hope we're not disturbing you.
No, not at all. Please come in.
I've arranged for us to view some local churches for the wedding ceremony.
Well, great. I just have some work to finish up here, and
but Cassandra's made appointments.
Oh, I see. Well, I'll just get my coat. I sort of imagined something a little less, I don't know, enormous.
St. Pierre's is one of the most sought-after wedding spots in all of Europe, and by a stroke of luck and a little pull, it's available for you this Sunday. Well,
Cassandra called in a lot of favors to arrange this. Royalty vies to be married in this church.
Oh, I'm sure they do. And it is incredible. It's just a little grander than the wedding that I had in mind.
Well, of course, it's up to you, dear. Oh, excuse me a moment.
What exactly did you have in mind?
Well, ever since I was a little girl, I've always dreamed of having a small, intimate little ceremony with just the closest friends and family. Maybe something outdoors.
Oh, lovely. And then afterwards, we can all chow down on barbecue and take turns swatting a piñata with a stick.
Well, that's not quite what I meant.
I think you're forgetting whom you're marrying.
Really?
Oliver will expect you to be his ally, mistress of his household, and hostess to kings and corporate heads. My daughter Emily understood that and embraced it. So why don't you just get on board and get over your childish dreams?
Check it out.
The staff is on call 24 hours, so if you need anything...
Hey, look! There's a moat!
I think we'll be fine, thanks.
What's that over there?
Well, my dear, that is the altar for the wedding. Oh, bring on the piñata.
Would you two like to see it?
Sure.
Come on.
That's the altar for Jenny's wedding? Jeez, it looks so plain. And that's all the people she's having? Mm. I've had bigger birthday parties.
It's a shame Ginny's so busy. She can't plan the grand wedding she really deserves.
It's for wedding day. It ought to be amazing. Hey, maybe we could help out. Pump it up a little.
Yeah, and we could call some more people.
Yeah, get some things going on.
Like doves and red carpets.
Maybe jugglers and those guys on stilts.
Yeah, and a carriage and some white horses.
Yeah.
I think it's precious. Showing the people you love just how much you love them. I'll even help you. It has to be our little secret.
All right. Cool. They got them. What size do you want? The biggest they got. Humongous. Check cakes off the list.
Cakes.
Hello, is this a circus? You're not for parties. Money is no object.
What is this?
It only comes in puce?
Puce?
Invitations? Oh, no, not you, Wendy. Let me call you right back. What is Oliver doing?
Hello? Oliver, how's Barcelona?
Jenny, she's off shopping again. What's your number? I have my pen handy. 6521. I'll have her call you the instant she returns. Ciao.
Hello? Yes? Bookings for what? Right, I'm kind of busy that day. Can you, occupé? Tray occupé? Yeah. Can you hold on, please? Whoops. Oh. Hello? Yes.
Okay.
Oh, I'm waiting for you, Tom.
Okay. Up you go.
I don't
Here
know
we
why.
Go. All right.
Well, let me get your number. Yeah, wait, let me get your number. I don't have her number, Dad.
She'll call you back.
No, I don't have her number, Dad.
Come on. Come on. Come on, right? Don't make me carry you. Come on. Whoa.
No, I need coffee on an IV drip. I've got a huge presentation in 2 days, a wedding in 3, and you know how I always wanted a little small wedding? Well, mm-hmm. Now the guest list is quintupled, and mm-hmm. That is definitely
okay,
not a word.
Big
I
breath.
Need more chairs,
big
more flowers.
Breath. In, out, relax. Better? Okay. Now you listen to me. Your whole life, you have insisted on doing it all yourself, and by some miracle, you've been able to pull it off. But, honey, you can't do everything.
I can't do anything, Dad. Not anything right, that is.
It's not true.
It is true. I'm letting down everyone around me, especially Katie and Alex.
It's not true. Those kids adore you. So does their dad.
Oliver. Who am I kidding? I mean, look at all this. I don't fit into this life. All these villas and castles. I'm a working class girl from an LA tract home. Daddy, I did not mean that the way it sounded.
I know, Jen. Jen, you are my princess. You worked hard, pulled yourself up, found your way into this fairy tale. Believe me, honey, you belong.
Not according to Nell. She hates me.
Honey, Nell's just afraid. See, she's pretty much alone in this world. She's afraid that the kids will forget about their birth mom and forget about their grandma.
I would never let that happen.
I know. I tell you what. You let me worry about Nell. You just start taking care of yourself and accept a little bit of help. And as far as this wedding is concerned, well, I'd suggest you talk to that fellow you're going to marry.
What would I ever do without you?
Oh, he got tied up with some politicos in Barcelona. Didn't he call? Well, he'll be here this evening, the latest tomorrow morning. Wow! Here's me thinking you're having a small ceremony. There must be 200 seats here.
250. I don't know how this all got so out of control.
Well, it comes with the territory. A man of Oliver's stature knows a lot of people. It's a shame. Seems to me it should be a quiet time.
You know, intimate.
No, it's supposed to be a wedding. It's supposed to be my wedding. I'm sorry.
Hey. It's not that bad, is it? Listen, guys like Oliver, they do things the big way. They can't help themselves.
Oliver's not usually like this.
Listen, I've known Oliver since I was very young, and, well, he burns his name on skyscrapers all over the world. He builds big, successful companies, and he does things like this.
I don't understand why he would do this without telling me.
Listen, I'm sure he's only doing it because he wants you to know how special you are to him.
You really think so?
Oops.
Jenny, get real.
I saw it, Kate. She was making out with Michael.
Don't just verbalize. Digitize. Show me some proof.
I saw what I saw. If you want to ignore it, that's fine. I'm not.
My darlings.
Get the lights.
You're supposed to be in bed.
Seamus.
Yes, sir.
Any clue what's going on here?
I had a dream like this once. Not a very pleasant one.
Oliver! Did you have a productive trip?
Yes, yes, very. In fact, I have some big news for Jenny. What is all this?
Well, had I known your fiancé intended a wedding soiree fit for the royal family...
There must be 200 chairs here.
250 and growing.
I don't get it. Jenny said she wanted a small, simple ceremony.
Well, a person's social status changes, so can her taste.
I don't know why she didn't call me about this. I left several messages for her.
And I made sure she received them.
Reload the cannon!
Well, I'll talk to her. Where is she?
I know how you feel, Arnie. I do. But you must remember, this is Jennifer's special day, and this is the wedding of her dreams. I wouldn't say a word.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Maybe we can at least put up a tent. A circus tent.
Very well, sir. As soon as Jenny returns from her fitting, I'll bring her to see you.
Right, and not a clue about where she's going.
Dad, we've got to talk. It's about...
Stuff!
Stuff?
Stuff! You know, like, how cool is that you're marrying Jenny?
Jenny!
Dad, I saw her in her wedding dress. And may I say so, she looked awesome.
Totally.
Oh. Totally awesome.
Okay, good. I'm glad we had this talk.
I think you cracked a rib, you doof. I would have cracked your skull, but there's obviously nothing up there. Alex, you can't go rat on Jenny without meat proof.
I told you, I saw her.
Alone with Michael in his arms.
Really, it could have meant anything.
You may be right, okay? But we just don't have the proof. So this is what we do.
Go through Jenny's purse?
No. And don't you ever dare do that to me or any other woman, by the way. Brigitte? Where this purse goes, Jenny goes. And where Jenny goes, we go.
So, Seamus, where are we going?
Can you still hear him?
Almost done with the
set. Hold on, they're breaking up.
It's just around the corner.
They're stopping just ahead. Come on.
I like what you want to do, but we'll need to maintain the facade.
Yeah, should be fine. I want the officers up really tough. See?
Hold on a second, please. Hello.
Hey.
So, what do you think?
Well, it's beautiful, but what is it?
The new world headquarters of CCI Tech Housing.
World headquarters?
Yeah. Let me show you around.
Bought the whole building. From now on, we'll run the entire operation from right here. And look at this view. Isn't it spectacular?
You mean when we're visiting Los Angeles, right?
No, actually, we considered several locations in the States, but since this is going to be an international company now...
I thought that Vienna was the most logical, centralized country.
Yeah, for the company. But what about for us?
And the kids, have you told them we're going to move here?
Move here? Did she say move here? Who can hear with all your yapping?
I didn't think I had to. I mean, they are my kids.
Oh. So...
Their opinions don't matter when it comes to making decisions.
Look, change is hard, but if people really want to, they can adjust to anything.
Sure. People can adjust to lots of things, like...
Prison, for example. Why don't we just put Katie and Alan behind bars and see if they can adjust to that?
Okay, maybe I am overreacting a little bit, but I just think that we need to start making these decisions as a family.
I agree.
Otherwise, Katie and Alex are going to start to feel like they're... hurting.
They're in the way. They're in our way. You know, why don't we just ship them off to boarding school? You know what I mean?
We're a family now. We'll always be together. Liars.
I agree. I understand exactly what you're saying. I wish there was some way around this, but Cassandra, Michael, and I have explored all the options.
Michael, huh?
He especially feels it's in our best interest.
Oliver, there's something I've been meaning to tell you about Michael.
Michael? Michael? Where is Michael?
In the library, I believe, sir.
I never should have told you.
Of course you should.
Well, well. Speak of the devil.
I want a word with you.
And I, you. In fact, we all would. Wouldn't we, gentlemen?
And ladies. What is this? I didn't call for a board meeting.
We did.
What's going on?
Always so coy and unassuming. Michael?
Our secret's out, darling.
What?
You stay away from her.
Me? Oliver, I'm sorry, but you've got the wrong impression. You see, every time you turn your back, your fiancé, she's all over me.
That's a lie.
Jenny, pictures don't lie.
Well, these pictures do. Oliver, I don't know what they're trying to...
How do you explain this?
Yes. We're all dying to know.
Oliver. Look at me. Tell me you don't believe any of this.
I don't know what to believe.
Well, then I guess I don't either.
Yes, sir.
Help Nell get the kids packed up. She'll be taking them home with her.
Certainly, sir.
Is Jenny all right?
She seemed a little upset.
Yes, well, there may not be a wedding after all.
I see. And you, sir, are you...
I'll be staying here. There's work to do.
I'll sign over the children's stock to you whenever you're ready.
Katie?
There you are.
Thank you, Seamus.
I'll get the other case.
Hey, Sam.
Hi.
Listen, have you seen the kids? Really, like to get them out of here.
Oliver, I just need to say this one thing before Jenny and I head home. Jenny wasn't raised with a lot of money, and, well, I may not be the classiest guy you ever met. But my daughter was raised to tell the truth. And if I were a betting man, which, from time to time, I am. I'd bet on my daughter.
You're wrong, you know. You are one of the classiest guys I ever met.
I can't seem to find Kate and Alex anywhere. I wanted to say goodbye to them.
Oh, I thought they were with you. They're probably still up in their rooms.
No, I already looked there. They're not. Brigitte! Brigitte, have you seen Kate and Alex?
I promise not to say.
Oh, this is just nonsense.
Brigitte, we need to know where they are.
Why? So you can ship them off to boarding school? Make your life simpler? We heard everything. Check your purse.
You said that about my grandchildren?
Oh, no. No, I mean, yes, I did say it, but I didn't mean it that way. Brigitte, you misunderstood us, I promise.
Brigitte, please, if you know where my children are, tell us.
I am not certain where they are, but I do know where they went.
Look in your jacket pocket.
Kids have my wallet and the honeymoon tickets.
Oh, no.
Seamus, quick, to the train station.
Get your camera. The Caldwell brats have run away. Leave immediately.
You have the tickets?
Yep, right here.
Oh, no. I took Dad's whole wallet, credit cards and everything. Should I call him? We're running away, you doof. We'll send it to him.
You check the platform. I'll find out when the next train leaves for Switzerland.
Jenny?
Any sign of them?
No, not yet. Don't worry, honey. Katie and Alex are experienced travelers. They'll be just fine.
They'd better be. If anything happens to those children, I'll never forgive you.
That's it.
Jenny?
No, that is it. I have tried to understand why it is that you dislike me so much. You've never even tried to get to know me. But one thing you should know by now is that I would never want anything to happen to Katie and Alex. I love them.
But they're my grandchildren.
But just because I love them too doesn't mean I would ever want to take away their mother's memory. I know how precious that is. I lost my mother too.
Track 11. Leaving now.
At least Oliver and Jenny are on board with them.
Unfortunately, without either money or identification.
Oh. Me and Mally talked you into this.
No? No one's gonna ship us off to any boarding school.
Hey, guys.
Well, fact is, we don't have any. But if I could just get up and see my kids.
90 Swiss francs each.
We both left our money back in Vienna. My purse fell off.
My children are running away, and they took our tickets.
We don't need them. We can make it just by our wits. You and me, living off the land.
Crème brûlée pour mademoiselle, chocolat mousse for monsieur. Bon appétit.
Passport? We are coming to the Swiss border.
We don't have our passports either. They were in the
purse. But this is ridiculous. I'm going up to see my kids.
You can't leave
us
here.
My children are alone on this train.
Please,
come on. They're on there by themselves. Hold on.
Hey, Alex.
Hold on.
Come on, give us your germ, why don't you? Jeez.
Sorry.
Thank hey! Hog one.
Hey!
This is great. We've lost the kids and we're going to miss a stockholders meeting tomorrow.
So what's the plan?
You know, Jenny, this may come as a surprise to you, but I don't always come equipped with a plan.
Well, Oliver, I don't always expect you to have one, but considering the fact that we're penniless, stranded, and approaching the Swiss border without passports, I thought it would be a good time to come up with one.
Yeah? Well, maybe you're right.
Well, thank you.
Of course, the last time we made a plan together didn't turn out quite the way I hoped.
For me, either.
Then why don't you try explaining to me about those pictures?
Well, why don't you try trusting the woman you were going to marry?
Because...
What? What?
Follow me. Now I have a plan.
We don't have any money. How are we going to pay for this? I thought that was your favorite watch.
It's just stuff. Doesn't matter.
So beautiful.
Yeah, it sure is.
Sad. In other circumstances, this would be so romantic. It's a shame that it's wasted on us.
Maybe it's not a complete waste. Right over there, man.
You've been here before?
A long time ago.
Whoa, I suddenly got deja vu.
You've been here before? Like, ooh.
No, Shaggy. Here. For real.
Clearing next to the river. I'll see if I can set down there.
Hey, I remember this place now. You do? Come on. This is it. Right here.
Wow.
How come I don't remember? You were at camp. I was 4 or 5, so your mom got so sick. I was really scared about it. So Dad took off work and came up here with me. He said a fairy lived in that castle. If you closed your eyes and wished really hard and believed, anything you dreamed would come true.
And you bought that?
Back then, I believed that stuff.
Come on,
let's go find a hotel.
Don't look now. It's that ball guy from the train.
I told you not to look.
Let's ditch him. Okay. 1, 2, 3.
Here we are!
Get
calm down. Everything's all right. Who's following you?
He's bald. And he has a camera.
You!
All right, buddy. I've had it with you. I want you to stay away from my family. And give me that film. Come on, hand it over. Who are you working for?
Halt, Duda.
What are you doing?
No. Don't arrest me. Arrest him. This guy's been following my children. Dad. He just stopped.
John, you got the wrong guy. Dad. The guy's some kind of crook.
Are you okay? Your grandmother and Sam are frantic.
Yeah, we're fine. Tell them not to worry.
And the police arrested your dad?
Yeah, they threw him in jail. I think he's stuck there for the night. Brigitte, you've got to help us. Stall the shareholders meeting tomorrow as long as you can.
Okay, I'll do it. Hold on, someone's coming.
He's on his way right now.
And he has photos of Oliver being arrested?
Resisting arrest. He says those are the best ones.
I can't wait. When does he get here?
Midnight tonight.
Splendid. Just in time for tomorrow's front page.
Okay, I'll see you tomorrow.
Meantime, I'll try to digitize,
not verbalize. Ciao.
Bye, Brigitte. Love you, babe. Ew! Love you, babe? Give me a break. I'm new at this.
Dad!
Katie? Alex, hey, you guys.
Dad, we've got to get you out of there.
Don't worry, I'm okay. Where's Jenny?
She's inside trying to make bail. Dad, we're sorry we ran away and made you worry. You might miss your big meeting, and because of us, you might lose everything.
Hey, none of that now. Come on. It's just a business. Can always start another.
But everything's all messed up. You and Jenny, our family.
Well, people have ups and downs in life, you know, and sometimes there are misunderstandings. And that's okay as long as you learn from them. But I want you guys to listen to this. No matter what happens, nobody loves you two more than Jenny and me. And nothing is going to change that. I promise. Okay?
Okay.
Ma'am, there's a gentleman here to see you and young Mr. Oliver.
Mr. Grimaldi, I trust you had a pleasant trip.
Give me this.
Let me see.
Fantastico.
My dear brother, this is going to work.
It's great.
We have to.
Hey, I thought I tucked you guys in bed.
We were just talking about making a deal with you.
Well, what kind of a deal?
We go off to boarding school, willingly.
No running away, no messing up in class, and no tormenting the teachers. All you have to do is get back together with Dad.
Do we have a deal?
Boarding school, huh? We're back to this again. I thought we straightened all that out.
We figured you just didn't want to hurt our feelings.
And that you just wanted us gone so you could be alone with Dad.
Gone? You guys, there is nothing that I want more than to be with the two of you every day. All day, all year.
And why did you break up with Dad?
Your dad and I, we have less in common than I thought. And I'm not sure that I fit into his fancy world.
But Jenny, all that fancy stuff doesn't make us happy. You're our world, Jenny. And we want you to stay in it.
Come here. You guys,
are the most amazing kids anybody could ever wish for. And I love you both. Forever. No matter what happens, okay?
Come on, Dad, no time to waste.
No kidding, the meeting's set for one.
Jenny said we missed our train.
Where is Jenny?
She's getting us a ride. Come on!
See you at the meeting, brother dear.
Ta-ta, Cass.
Uncle Michael! Miss Fax, just came in. Full you from Granddad Carl.
What does he want now?
Pick him up at the docks and take him to the meeting. Well, why didn't he call me earlier?
Fool's gone senile. Take me here.
Well, hurry up, you fool. Go, go!
Divide and conquer.
There she is! Jenny! Jenny!
Come on, you guys. The boat's this way. Down here. Hurry, meeting.
Is the Edelweiss.
Hey, you! Where's the Edelweiss? It should be right here.
Out there?
Well, how on earth am I supposed to get out there?
I think you...
May I have your attention, please? The votes have been tabulated, and the merger has passed. Now, with the merger in place, it is time for you, the investors, to vote and decide who will lead CCI Techhausen into the future.
Where is Oliver Caldwell?
Are the tabloid stories true?
Are they true? No comment. We assumed he would be here by now.
Nell, this really is too much. Sorry. I have no choice.
Please, give him 10 more minutes. I know he'll be here.
Oh, we seem to have a few more moments. So here is a short presentation that I created for your enjoyment.
Welcome to the new CCI Techhausen. Our family working for yours.
She created? That's Jenny's program.
Excuse me, but where are you taking me? I'm looking for a boat. You know, the boat? I don't see the boat. What is this? What are you doing? What are you doing?
What are you doing? Are you insane? Where are you going? Please, come back, please!
Are there any nominations from the floor?
I nominate Cassandra Hausen.
Carl, please wait.
Are there any other nominations?
I nominate Oliver Caldwell.
I'm afraid that's not possible. Our bylaws require that the candidates be present at this meeting. Then I will ask for acclamation by voice vote. All those in favor, please say.
Wait, point of order. I move that we reopen the nominations.
I am sorry, but the voting was already underway.
The motion is before this body to reopen the nominations.
I second that!
How do you explain this, Mr. Caldwell?
What about these pictures, Mr. Caldwell?
These photos were part of a plot to discredit Jennifer Morgan and me.
A plot that was financed by, I'm sorry, Mr. Hausen, but the whole thing was planned by Cassandra and Michael Hausen.
Thank you.
This is ludicrous. These charges are sheer fantasy.
fantasy. There is not a shred of truth to the allegations that this felon and his ex-nanny have leveled against me.
Oh, Mr. Grimaldi, these pictures are smashing.
Fantastic.
You're a true artist. Here's $20,000 now. I'll give you the rest tomorrow.
You see this? This will be the nail in Oliver's corporate coffin.
I'm being framed. Can't you see? This is a setup. It's a double made up to look like me!
Father's going to go absolutely bonkers. The old fool will have to back me up for CEO now.
I've been framed!
This old fool nominates Oliver Caldwell for president and CEO.
Please. Please. Thank you. I appreciate the nomination. It's what I've always wanted. Or at least I thought I did. But last night, as I was lying in my jail cell, I realized how preoccupied I've been lately with trying to make this merger happen. And that the people paying most dearly for that have been my children. Alex, Katie, come on up here. It would be daunting enough for me to be president of this new company. And if you're kind enough to approve me for that, I will happily fill that position. But as for CEO, I nominate Carl Hausen for chief executive officer. And lastly, I would like to nominate Jennifer Ann Morgan, whose creativity and charm has been indispensable to me and to CCI, to be our new vice president of European operations. And if she will have me, I would like to ask her once again to please be my wife.
Richer for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish from this day forward as long as you both shall live.
I do.
I now pronounce you man and wife.
Camera.
Mom, Dad, we got it covered. Don't worry about a thing. Mom, I like that.
I want you to keep it. Sort of a mother-daughter wedding gift.
I'll treasure it.
Welcome to the family, Jenny.
Take care, you guys!
Bye! 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 B
Oh, my God.